President Trump and his supporters have contributed to this violent rhetoric as well.
Look at the way Donald Trump talks about his opponents. He calls them communists and fascists and far left thugs and vermin.
I do want to point out, just for fairness, I don't want to get into an argument about this, but the former president himself has also used that kind of rhetoric.
I say now is the time to talk about the common denominator when it came to this assassination attempt is America's fascination and obsession with owning guns.
It was, you know, a 20-year-old lone wolf, white, whack job with easy access to a gun. And we have to have a conversation about that, because it wasn't a drag queen. It wasn't an immigrant. It wasn't a pissed off liberal woman. This is, and this keeps happening.
No matter who the shooter, what the shooter's motives were, no matter who the shooter is, you are going to hear conspiracy theories going forward.
The shooter, he was a registered Republican. He also donated $15 to Act Blue in 2021, which is an odd thing, but he was a Republican.
Trump was the victim today. It is possible that tomorrow it'll be someone that Trump identifies as a threat, you know? And
yeah.
So it really is, do we want to live like this?
I think we need to have an honest and real conversation about real gun control legislation.
Okay.
Donald Trump dodged a bullet. But he's not the only one. America dodged a bullet last night, because if that thing had been a quarter inch over, you would have had an assassination. And then I don't know how this country comes back from that, because half the country would have felt that the other half of the country took their leader. And if only a small percentage of those people felt that means we're in a war, you have millions of people ready to shoot back.
We could also see him say what I believe was fight. That was his first instinct. And this is a country divided. We saw the violence yesterday, the horrific violence yesterday. And we've seen it in places. And we've also seen this morning, we've heard President Trump say he wants the country to come together, to be united. But others are directly pointing the finger at President Biden, with, of course, no evidence that he incited this or had anything to do with this assassination attempt.